I love the character of Stephanie because she's such a geek in certain ways. She tries so hard, and she's very sort of invisible in certain ways, or mocked by the other moms at school. And she knows it. She's not unaware of that. And she has reached out into the universe through her blog to all these moms, you know, around the country. And those have become her surrogate friends. So she's a very lonely character. She's also a character who's really haunted by her past. And that has informed her entire persona to be sort of the perfect mom, because she's making up for some sins of the past. I'm fascinated by Emily. I think she's very enigmatic. She's incredibly beautiful, which was important in the book and in the casting. But she's a certain kind of beauty. I mean, there are different ways to be beautiful. And I think she is a beauty that's sort of scary to men and to women. And it's partly because she's hard to pin down. She keeps a lot of things close to the vest. And her facade of being glamorous and fashionable and slick and smooth really hides her past. So interestingly, she and Stephanie both have dark pasts, but they choose to hide them in different ways. One by like baking healthy cookies and having this mommy blog, and the other by working in a slick fashion PR job, which is all about surfaces and all about mystique. And so it's a perfect world for her to inhabit. One of the best compliments I got from Paul was that he said when he first read my script, that every 10 pages he went, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, because there were so many corkscrew twists and turns. And that's true in the book, although it's even more true in the script. We went for a couple extra ones. And he loved that, you know, and it's in the genre, and we're in a way leaning into that, leaning into the genre and adding twist upon twist upon twist. But we're doing it very consciously. It's not to be ridiculous, but it's to embrace the genre and say, we know what genre we're in.